You must have heard of neurons in biology and how they work. In artificial intelligence, we have a similar concept called neural networks. We have learned three different terms: artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning. Deep learning is done with the help of neural networks. These neural networks are loosely modeled after how neurons in the brain behave. They are able to extract the data features, that is the type of data that you want to collect, automatically without needing the input of the programmer. A neural network is essentially a system of organizing machine learning algorithms to perform certain tasks. They are fast and efficient way to solve problems. Let us understand the structure of neural networks. The basic units are called nodes. These are represented by circles, as you can see. They simulate the functioning of a neuron within a neural network. These nodes can transmit signals between each other by means of connections called edges. So edges are lines with the arrows between nodes. Through these edges, signals are sent by the neuron, which in turn passes on to the next neurons or the nodes in artificial neural networks. The first layer is the input layer. The job of the input layer is to acquire the data and pass it on to the next layers in the neural network. So no processing happens in the input layer. Next to these are the hidden layers. There can be multiple hidden layers, as you can see. In the given picture, there are three hidden layers. As the name indicates, these layers are hidden, which means they are not visible, and they have their own machine learning algorithm based on which they would work. The last layer is the output layer. This layer passes the final processed data to the user. Like the input layer, output layer also does not do any processing. It only gives the final output to the user. This is another representation of neural network here. As you can see, in the input layer, there are three nodes which take the data from the user as input and passes this on to the first hidden layer of the multiple hidden layers. And each node in this hidden layer has its own machine learning algorithm and hidden rules. The output of each node is fed to all the other nodes of the next layer. As you can see, the output of each node is given to the subsequent nodes of the next hidden layer, and which in turn is sent to the output layer. So the output layer gives the final output, which is sent to the user. This is how the neural networks work. As seen in the given figure, the larger the size of neural networks, the better is the performance. Whereas in the traditional machine learning algorithm, they stop improving after a certain saturation point. So we feed in a huge amount of data and get better performance with the help of neural networks. Some of the features of neural network are: these are systems which are modeled on the human brain and the nervous system. They are able to automatically extract the data features without the input from the programmer. Every neural network is essentially a machine learning algorithm, and it is useful when solving problems for which the data set is huge or very large. So these are the four features of a neural network. Now let us compare this with the human nervous system. Impulse is received through dendrites and passed on to the cell body. The cell body performs the activation on the impulse and then sends it to the next neuron through the axon terminals. The axon terminal of every neuron in turn would be connected to the dendrite of the next neuron and so on. So this way, the impulse is sent to the next set of neurons, which in turn sends it to the cell body, where the activation takes place, and then the result is sent out through the axon terminals. We can compare the same with the artificial neural network, wherein the input layer gets the data, which it passes on to the nodes in the hidden layer. The nodes then perform specific actions on the data and pass on the processed information to the subsequent layers. In the end, the final processed data reaches the output of the artificial neural network system. Now, we can understand and derive an analogy of the components of artificial neural network with the human nervous system. The input layer of neural network can be compared to the dendrites of the input neuron in the human brain and nervous system. The nodes can be compared to the neurons, and the output layer can be compared to the axon terminals of the output neuron. So in this session, we have learned the structure of neural network, the features of neural network, and how the neural networks work. We also learned to compare the human brain and nervous system with artificial neural networks. With this, we come to the end of this session. I hope you have understood the concepts clearly. Please do like, share, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.